Hi folks, this is all the fruit, and I'm at Taman Suntex community market in the outskirts of Kuala Lumpur. I came here for hiking, but then I saw this big modern market building and thought, why not? So this is not one of the souvenir markets in the center of Kuala Lumpur. It's also not one of the huge, sprawling fruit and veg markets in the center of Kuala Lumpur. This is one of those, normal, modern, suburb grocery markets. I guess there must be dozens of them in the area around Kuala Lumpur. So let's see what they have here. Some bananas. Not sure what those are. Maybe I should ask later. Ginger, dog fruit, or I call them stink nut, lemongrass. Those could be stink bean. Oh yeah, stink beans. Stink beans. And here the whole beans. Corn. A guy who's selling lots of different honeys. Here some street food vendor. This lady basically has the same stuff as the other guy, yeah? Just apart from ginger, she also has some galang and curcuma, and also some chilies. Here is the durian vendor, who is of course outside the building and who just sold me a very tasty durian. I got this as durian clone or durian variety 88, however he pulled it. When I pulled out durians from his pile, he named everyone by a different name. Well, who am I to judge? Let's see, here is the meat and fish section. I guess very interesting for some of you, but for me as a vegetarian, I'm gonna skip this one. Well, there must be a fresh coconut seller somewhere, because there are fresh coconuts around here. It's around noon, so the market is kind of being... vacated right now, but let's see what we can get. Here we have some... This is lotus. Those are lotus rhizomes. A big pomelo. Different types of limes. Oh, here's some pineapple. And I forgot what this tasty vegetable here is. Cucumbers. Cabbage. As you can see, at least half of the stalls are empty. I guess, like a lot of infrastructure in Southeast Asia, this market was built as big as possible and cannot be completely filled up. Well, let's see here. All those different greens, which I don't know. Green papayas, green mangoes, and green bananas for cooking, together with cabbage, green cucumbers for cooking. Those are green cucumbers for salad. Different types of bananas. I should check out if they have a lot of different varieties here than in Borneo. Little kasturi limes, moringa, smaller bananas. Those are some eggplants. Some quite interesting type of spaghetti bean. I don't think I've seen some with this type of surface ever before. Zucchini, tomatoes, round eggplants, chayote, radishes, red cabbage, what was this, Mauritius papida, or what was this called? Oh, somebody even told me in a comment recently what this called, that I forgot again. Lettuce, bitter gourd, name, and broccoli. Carrots. Here are the normal type spaghetti beans, just next to some rich gourds. More rich gourds, and I don't know what those waxy long snake gourd type like are called. Those are really long spaghetti beans. Here we have the normal salad cucumber, and next to it, those are cooking cucumbers, and those could be either a different type of salad cucumber or just unripe cooking cucumbers, which you can use as salad cucumbers. Here's some more different cucumbers, some more different bitter gourds, some more different pumpkins and squashes, some more different cucumbers. They sure have a big diversity of cucumbers. And again, all those greens. Well, this is some brassicaceae. This is Chinese morning glory. I don't even know what this is. I even saw it harvested somewhere on YouTube, but I forgot. Oh, are those tiny cute little pak choys? Well, those are the normal ones, but what are those? Those look really cute. And those also seem to be some brassicaceae, which they use a lot. Here a stall with mostly exotic fruits. The pomelos and the dragon fruit should be local, but the pears, oranges, apples, more pears, grapes, more apples, kiwis, plums, more oranges. All those should be imported, I'm pretty sure. Here also some imported kakis. Older fruits, they basically sell them per basket for a cheaper price. What do we have here? Here we have the dry goods section, and since potatoes and onions and garlics are classified as dry goods, they are usually sold in a dry goods section. And yes, sometimes you can also sell stuff like moringa and cooking plantains here. This is either some, I think this is the inside of some banana stems, which is also used for cooking. Here, more exotic fruit like apples, pears, and subtropical oranges and grapes. They sure like their grapes and kakis and pomegranates. I think the ones which are like this, like bright red, they are usually from subtropical areas and not from here. Pineapples, lots of soursop. I've never seen so much soursop in Malaysia before. Papayas and small bananas, and this could be the big pisang tandok, but I'm not sure. The people are grinning, so maybe I got the banana right. I came here with a whole backpack full of mangoes, and look, here I get mangoes which are just as good, and I could have come without all my mangoes and could have bought mangoes here. What a pity. Some different bananas. Here the bananas are quite expensive for some reason. Don't ask me why. Well, broccoli and cauliflower. Here we have some okra. Basically all the standard stuff. Some normal short beans. Ah, here dragon beans. Coriander and other herbs and spices. I recognize not even half of them. Here is again some artemisia, and here some basil, and here some lime leaves. This could be again coriander, fresh garlic, bok choy, lemongrass. Well, what is this? I think this is maybe some ginger type thing, but I'm not sure. Banana leaves, which I use for wrapping basically everything. Ah, this here is manioc. Young manioc stems. I don't even know what they use them for. Here we already have a lot of stuff which is probably just being harvested somewhere in the wild, like those ferns. Well, here the meat and fish section. Okay, we're gonna stay away from it. What else have we got here? Some more green mangoes for cooking. Some bigger bitter gourds and some smaller bitter gourds. Three different types of limes. Tiny elongated eggplants. Pink bananas and teeny tiny bananas. Some quite big limes and those warty limes. Here again, this small elongated eggplant and pea eggplant. And we already reached the dry fruit section from a different site. Well, folks, this was an overview over a modern, normal-sized suburb grocery market in the outskirts of Kuala Lumpur. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the beautiful city of Kuala Lumpur. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.